It's no doubt that the agriculture sector employs over 80% of Ugandans along the entire value chain, although the biggest percentage remains under the small-scale production. Ironically, not much funding is allocated to the sector, which according to many observers could shift many Ugandans out of poverty. For instance, Simsim and maize alike have been on the market for long, but with no standards. So farmers have lost billions of shillings due to poor farming methods, pre- and post-handling to the export period.
Small-scale farmers produce their maize, but issues of standards are not, they are not very common at that level. But also slow to the value chain, from the people who produce, the people who store maize, the people who transport it, the people who mill it, you know. So we thought we should work on this issue.
Almost at each point of the value chain, the highest losses being post-harvest losses, and it can go to a very big percentage. There is a lot that must be done there. And all sorts of post-harvest losses because of the practices that we are currently using.
Data from the Ministry of Agriculture indicates that Uganda produced 93.563 metric tons of simsim in 2010. This has been dropping and was quoted at $11 million in 2012 compared to $17.3 million in 2011. This is now being blamed on government's failure to include the seed oil among the strategic intervention crops for the export market. Siatini is now spearheading a campaign to develop standards for simsim, mainly grown in Lira, Soroti, Gulu, Amoro, and exported to China, India, Turkey, and Saudi Arabia.
Simsim has also very, very big potential. Like I said, we are passionate about it. It's a woman's crop. But it also has a lot of potential. You were asking, where is the market? Here. Domestic market. Regional market, China, India, the Arab countries, everywhere, you know. So if we put our house in order, simsim also has a lot of potential.
There will be baseline surveys, see where are we as far as standards are concerned, and later on, where have we reached. And basically the impact of trading out of poverty. Two is the message also of helping the issue of gender, women, who are actually the core at the farm level in most of our regions.
This applies to maize too, which has seen over 100,000 metric tons of Ugandan maize rejected by Tanzania in 2013 due to poor quality. Through the 18-month project, farmers will receive training and capacity building, research and information generation, and will commence with Lira, Nakaseke and Masindi. Through the program, the two organizations hope to see a reduction in maize and simsim metric tons rejected at the borders, increase incomes of households, especially women, and increase the pricing of the commodities. Currently, a kilo of simsim ranges between 5,000 to 6,000 shillings, and maize remains the crop with a high export potential for East African region, with Kenya importing 3,670,000 metric tons annually, with a deficit of 600,000, while Uganda exports 250,000 metric tons annually. Reporting for Urban TV, I'm Simon Oktela.